A long time ago, on the top of Mount Ninsaku, 9 families formed from ripe bunches of bananas. These 9 families were the sole inhabitants of the world. They made their journey down the mountain and settled in West Saram, which was also known as the 9 Dance Grounds. Among these 9 families was a man named Ameta. Ameta was unmarried and did not have any children of his own. One day, Ameta and his dog went hunting in the jungle. The dog spotted a wild pig and began to chase it. The chase ended at the edge of a deep pond when the pig jumped in. Unable to swim, the animal drowned. Ameta ventured into the water to retrieve the pig. As he pulled the pig onto the land, he found an odd object on the end of its tusk. It was the world's first coconut. Although Ameta did not know what the coconut was, he brought his new prized possession home with him, set it on a table, and covered it with a cloth. That night, when Ameta went to sleep, a man appeared to him in his dream. The man told him he must go and plant the coconut right away. Ameta listened to his vision and planted the coconut. 3 days went by, and the coconut had sprouted and had already become a tall palm tree. Another 3 days went by, and the tree had blossomed. Ameta, proud of his tree and thirsty, decided to climb the tree and cut the blossom to prepare himself a drink. In the process, he accidentally cut his hand and his blood spilled on the leaves below. Ameta left the tree to bandage his hand and 3 days later went back to check on his tree. When he arrived at the tree, he was surprised at what he saw. The blood from his hand and the sap from the blossom mixed together and created a face in the tree. Once again, Ameta left the tree and returned to it 3 days later. By this time, the tree not only had a face, but also had a body. It was then Ameta realized that a little girl had formed in the tree. That night, Ameta had another vision of the same man from his first dream. The man told Ameta to go wrap the girl in his cloth and bring her home. Ameta did as was instructed, brought the girl home with him, and named her Hanuel. Bringing the girl home, it only took 3 days for her to become a young woman. It did not take long for Ameta to realize that his new adopted daughter was very different from everyone else. Whenever Hanuel would answer nature's call, she would excrement very valuable items including Chinese dishes and gongs. This special gift of hers made her father Ameta very rich. During this time, the 9 families were preparing to celebrate the Morrow Dance at the 9 Dance Grounds. This festival was going to last 9 nights and was to be celebrated at 9 different locations. At the Morrow Dance, the male dancers would form a 9-fold spiral, and the women would sit in the middle and pass out betel nuts to the men. After the celebration, everyone would return home in the morning. When the first night of the Morrow Dance occurred, Hanuel joined the women in the center to pass out betel nuts. During the second night of the festival, being celebrated at the second location, Hanuel was again placed in the middle of the dancers to pass out betel nuts. However, when a dancer asked for one of the nuts, Hanuel would hand them a piece of coral instead. Soon, everyone at the festival wanted a piece of coral. The families were mesmerized by Hanuel's gift. Again, on the third night, Hanuel was in the center of all the dancers. That night, she passed out Chinese porcelain dishes instead of nuts. These events continued throughout the duration of the festival. On the fourth night, Hanuel gave out larger dishes, and then big bush knives, followed by patel boxes made of copper. By the seventh night, she handed out golden earrings, and then gongs on the eighth night. As the festivities continued and the gifts increased in number and value, the families were getting more and more jealous of Hanuel's wealth and accused her of being a witch. Their solution? Kill her. At the ninth and final dance, Hanuel was placed in the center as usual, except this time the men had dug a deep hole in the same area. As the men danced, they forced Hanuel into the hole and began to bury her. Hanuel was buried alive as the dancers and women trampled her until dawn. The next day, when Hanuel failed to return home, her father immediately knew she had been killed. He went out to the jungle and found 9 branches to reconstruct the 9 circles of the Maro dancers in his home. As soon as this was finished, Ameta found out where she had been killed. He left his home, took 9 fibers from the coconut tree, and stuck them in the dance ground. There, he found the hair and blood of Hanuel. Immediately, Ameta dug up her body and cut it into many pieces. He took her body parts and buried them around the dance grounds, but took the arms with him. The parts that he did bury transformed into plants that would become food for the rest of the world. Ameta took Hanuel's arms to Satine, a Dema virgin and ruler of Westerane. Satine was furious with the humans for killing Hanuel, so she punished them. She built a 9-fold spiral gate and stood on a large log inside the gate, holding the hands of Hanuel. She summoned the people and told them she was going to leave them forever. Satine then explained to them that they must pass through the gate in order to stay human. If they failed to pass the gate, they would become animals and spirits. The people who did pass were separated into 2 groups that formed the tribes, the Fivers and the Niners. Satine then disappeared from Earth to live on the Mountain of the Dead in the southern part of Westerane. Only after one dies can one see her again. Since this time, animals and spirits have been living among humans, and the world has been supported by the food produced from Hanuel's body. From her death came new life.